Hi, I'm Rob with Precision Zone, and I'm going to be showing you how to perform some basic static checks on this Yaskawa SGMGH Sigma 2 series motor. Now, the first thing that we're going to go ahead and do is perform a megaohm test. And if you're performing this test inside the machine with your motor installed, you're going to want to make sure that you disconnect the cables from the drive. And then you can make through the cables or you can make directly from the motor. Now, you'll want to be doing this if you have a low insulation problem or a ground fault. Now, the megaohm test should be done with a megaohm meter, and you want one that can at least be at a 1,000-volt rating. So let's go ahead and find a good ground. And we're going to go ahead and set our meter to the 1,000-volt scale. On this specific meter, we need to press the release button. I'll take the test probe and put it on U. And we have 4,000 megs there. Go on V. 4,000 megs there. And let's go to W. We have 4,000 megs there. And as always, when you're using a megger, do not forget to make sure that you discharge all the electrical charge inside of that stator winding. Now that we've gone ahead and eliminated the fact of this motor being grounded, now let's go ahead and perform a phase-to-phase resistance test. Well, I'm also going to be using a quality digital multimeter for this test, and I'm also going to be showing you some differences between a milliohm meter, which is the most accurate way to perform this test, but for in the field, you can use a digital multimeter to get you close. So we're going to go ahead and turn our meter to the resistance setting. We'll take our test leads and we'll place one probe on the U phase and one probe on the V phase. You can see we got 0.4 ohms and we'll go U to W, 0.4 ohms and V to W, 0.4 ohms. Now they're nice and balanced across all three phases, but another check is that they need to be within 10% of one another. And on that test right there, you could say, hey, look, that's great. They're within 10% of each other. Now let's check the reading on a milliohm meter. Now we're getting a reading of about 0.05 ohms, which is a very big difference. Now a digital multimeter is gonna get you close, but as you saw, it's not gonna get you super accurate readings to find small problems. The multimeter is only going to be able to show you catastrophic damage with inside of a stator winding. If your servo motor is equipped with the holding brake, please see one of our other videos on how to check your servo motor holding brake. One last test that you can perform if the motor is outside of the machine is just simply rotate the shaft. You shouldn't feel any cogging at all. It should be nice and smooth, and it should have very little resistance. If your motor does have an oil seal installed, it will have a little bit more resistance than one without one. And if you have any more questions about how to static check an AC servo motor, please reach us at precisionzone.com. Thanks for watching.